Hello everyone. As of now, I would like to accelerate and to show you with slide 16, simply complexification of the very first presentation we had in slide 15. What the purpose right now with slide 16 is simply to introduce dynamics in the comparison of pre-tax and transfer and post-tax and transfers Gini indices from the 1980s to 2015, something more recent years, if you want. I remind you that all the slides are archived on this webpage, and on top of that, this PowerPoint will be available there. So, slide 16, what are we trying to do right now is simply to compare pre-tax and transfer and post-tax and transfer, before tax and transfers and after tax and transfers, if you want, between the mid-80s to the 2016. There is a small typo here since the before tax and transfer is in light blue on this slide. The question right now is dynamics, and we have to find a trick to compare over time the thing. The plan right for this presentation is, what is the purpose of slide 16? It's already done. We'll underline different concepts, but it's repetition of slide 15 in many respects. We'll see the Stata programming. We'll consider the LISSY implementation of those results, and I propose you exercises of generalization. So I will not insist too much. The question of Janet Gornick regarding slide 16 is, what about the dynamics of change in this domain? So what we do here is pedagogia de repetitio arte est. This slide is well known right now. And let's consider the big thing, the big concept we have to consider. So repetition of slide 15. We consider the Gini indices. We can do otherwise. There are many variants, but I will not insist on this. Important stuff is what to do with time dynamics. We will see that it's important to find a way to select an old year, a recent year, and do the match so that we can compare one with the other. We'll do that on 10 countries of the original slide 16 objective. We'll generalize this with another larger list in the exercises. We repeat disposable income after tax and transfer, pre-tax and transfers, factor incomes before tax and transfer, pre-tax and transfer. You have the synonyms, it's clear. We focus on the non-elderly population. Slide 15 is a choice of the original presentation we replicate here. And we'll have to do many standard things, such as LIS weighting, outliers, how to manage outliers, and other LIS routine treatments we saw in slide 15. On top of that, we have an issue of geographic harmonization. What's the matter? For instance, Germany, in the mid-80s, you had only Western Länder. Now Germany includes Eastern Länder of Germany. If we want to compare the mid-80s to nowadays, maybe we have to exclude today Eastern Länder. It's what we do. It's a choice. You can change this choice later. Same thing for France. France, 2010, has included overseas regions of France. It was not the case before. It affects the Gini index. What we do then is to select only mainland France to make a long-term harmonization of geography. It's your choice. You can change this. Before we see the program, we just have to launch WebUI. So I propose you some trick. We can launch a WebUI. It's a LISSY interface, if you want. Project LIS, package Stata, replication slide 16, if you want. And here in this window, we have to paste the program. The program is easy to find. On the home page of this series of sessions, the address is height here. Here is session 2 on slide 16. The program is archived right here. You click on it. Control A, select all. Control C, copy. On the web UI, you paste everything, Control V, and you run this example with that icon here. It's launched. If you jump to recent jobs, you have a new job here. Yeah, and we'll comment it in 7 minutes when it's finished. So, the program. In this program, what we do is we make a macro, a local string variable with list of countries we want to crunch. You will have to simply to change this list. We consider the mid-80s list of variable, the same kind of crunch than on slide 15, its repetition, and recent times. We append those two temporary data sets. We then select the very first and the very last year available in the data set for each country. So we are supposed to have two different years at this stage. And we exclude countries if first year and last year are the same. This would mean that we have only one sample for the country. So in that case, we cannot compare. After, what we do is a series of things we have seen on slide 16. Creation of interesting variables, suppression of bad weights. Here I just insist on something that I have forgotten to show in slide 15. That is, if you generate this useful descriptive weight, useful because it's compatible with frequency weight option in the comments, you can make use of this for descriptive purpose, such as Gini computation, such as tables, any kind of descriptive result. You must not make use of it for models, regressions, bootstraps, that kind of thing. Not sure for the bootstrap, but you have to test it. Head of household, we select, and we keep only non-elderly households. Here is our geographic harmonization. And then we begin the trick of indexation of country years to generate a loop of repetition of the same computations. Like in slide 16, here is the loop. We repeat those lines for each country year. We first have the trick of top and bottom coding, that is the standard of the key figures in LISSY key figures, and then the computation of the genies for pre and post tax and transfers things. We collapse those results here to have as many lines as we have country years, and due to our selection, we have a first year, we have a last year. This means that for each country, we have two lines. We index one for old times, two for recent times, and then we generate, we have a trick to reshape this table so that old values and new values will be on the same line for each country. And in after this reshape, each country is one line on the new dataset. I precise, I generate this simply to have a truncated value of genies for a nicer graph. And for a nicer graph here, you have a series of instructions to improve the quality of the graph, including a ranking of countries by declining level of Gini index of recent times after tax and transfer income inequality. And here a nice label of country year so that we know what we compare in the past and in the present times. A graph syntax, a bit complicated, but if you focus on it, you will understand what it is. And the last line is the magic wand that transforms a non-accessible stata graph in an export that will be available on the LISSY page. This graph export PDF is the one way to have vision of the graph on LISSY. So LISSY implementation, we did that 5 or 7 minutes ago. be aware that this run could need 7 minutes, depending on traffic jams. If we go to the result, what we can say is that it's already done. So on job text, you have job text is our Stata program, a repetition. The listing will give you an opportunity to see what is to be improved or not. And now you have the final graph showing the before and after tax and transfer dynamics for each set of countries. So this is on the slide, it's a copy paste. Beware that you have the post-tax and transfer Gini on the left. The pre-tax and transfer Gini, that is more unequal, of course, the pre-tax and transfer. And you see the dynamics of the different countries. You can provide different comments. Income inequality is increasing everywhere, at least on this list of 10 countries. The pre-tax and transfer Gini is going worse. The post-tax and transfer, the same. Some nice things could be observed on Nordic, European, Nordic countries. The pre-tax and transfer factor income, before tax and transfer incomes are much worse today than 30 years ago. But after tax and transfers, redistributions limit the intensity of increase of the Gini. And it's your turn to find your own comments here. Now, exercises, if you wish. You could include southern European countries, including Spain, Italy, France, maybe Greece, and see what happens. Second exercise, you can include Latin American countries. Be aware that in the 2000s, you have many Latin American countries. You cannot go back to the mid-1980s, so just change the time span of the first period, so until recent times, and then you can enjoy some final result with those set of three European countries, southern countries. You have a strange French result, but Spain and Italy look like the rest. You have a kind of French exception of declining inequalities when you compare the 80s to recent times. When now you include Latin American countries, you can see common traits for Uruguay and for all the other countries. You have a kind of convergence of the US with those countries in terms of Gini indices of disposable equalized incomes. But what you have on top of that is now Uruguay is almost southern European country similar to Spain. You can continue to add other country years, and then please enjoy. And thank you for your presence, and see you on the next session for new replication of slides. See you soon.